Hi there. If you find yourself having to work remotely or you work with what's considered distance education where you are not in the same classroom as students, maybe they are working from home at a larger distance and you're maybe in a central location, we just want to provide you a few options as to how you can leverage FreshGrade to get your lesson plans out and have them submit their learning and their work back to you as the teacher. So I'm just looking at a FreshGrade account here. What you can see is I have my class created as Nancy Brown. I've got all my students listed in portfolios, and as you can see, their portfolios are quite full already. We've been working quite a bit with them. But here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to flip over to this gradebook tab, and right here under Add Activity, if I click that, what this is going to do is going to allow me to generate a lesson plan that I can now submit out to my students. And if I've invited them into their FreshGrade account, which I'm going to show in just a quick minute, what's going to be able to happen is I can share out this entire lesson plan with them. They're going to be able to review the lesson, read the text, any resources that I add to it, and then they're going to be able to complete the work and then submit back to this particular activity, allowing them to again communicate back and forth with you giving them the lesson, them submitting their work, you providing an assessment and sharing that back out with students and parents. So very quickly, I'm not gonna go too far into details here, but if we just call this one test, what I can do in the description field is add in sort of any anecdotal notes or description of what this lesson plan is going to be. But I do want to just quickly jump down to resources here. What we found is a lot of people are leveraging some different ways of adding resources. And basically, if you have videos or anything that you can leverage, what we can do in FreshGrade is upload those videos as a resource so that your students can then watch those. So again, if you filmed a lesson plan, I just have one video example here that I'm just going to add in. What that allows me to do is add my video in so that students can watch that as a resource. Now, we handle a certain video length or video size. If you find yourself going over that, what you may want to do is leverage a Google Drive or even a YouTube video if you can, and then you can actually just put the link right into our web resource here. And what that's going to do is that's going to allow you to have maybe a longer video and share that out with students, and that just goes in as a hyperlink there, so when they click on it, they're able to access that. And one other thing that's actually really great is you're able to add an assessment scale. The last step is just making sure that I've got the right students selected. Again, you can pick all of them, none of them, or anywhere in between, and that should really help you create this lesson plan. Again, the resource tab is going to probably be your best friend in making sure that you get any sort of lesson plans out or rubrics or anything else that you want as a resource that you want your students to leverage. So very quickly, I just want to show you how to invite students if you haven't done that already. So I've added them into my classroom, and if I actually scroll over to portfolios, you can see the list of all of my students. But if I haven't added them in, what I'm going to do is click into their portfolio. I'm going to click Manage Parents. And now you can see with Jacob, I have added him, but there's going to be a button here that says I'm allowing Jacob access. Down below, as you can see, here's a username. I can reset the password and have all of that information there as well. Also, if I scroll down further, I can add parents. I can add their email addresses and move them into this account as well. So just wanted to quickly show you how to do that. If I wanted to move on to the next student, again, I can just repeat that process, make sure that they're going to be taking a look at this from a student's perspective now. So as you can see, I'm logging into the student account now. It's important to note that we do have the web application for students as well as mobile apps. If students are logging in through the mobile apps, they'll be able to upload pictures and specific items. The web application is going to probably be best if they're uploading documentations like a Word doc, let's say. So I'm just going to log in very quickly here. And what I do know is I was working in Miss Brown's grade 6 class. So as you can see here, I have that assignment shown up. And again, if I want to watch the video, I can watch the video right here. If I've added any web links to that, any links to maybe a YouTube video or even a video that I have in a Google Drive that I've shared with Jacob, Jacob then would be able to go in and do that. Once Jacob has completed work, he'd be able to submit that back using the upload feature here, could comment as well into the assignment. And by uploading content back in, it's going to go straight back to you as the teacher. So hopefully this helps you in trying to figure out sort of that distance education or even remote work style of delivering lesson plans to students and having them submit work back to you. And if you do have any questions, feel free to reach out to FreshGrade.